Hi everyone, today we have a guest rant from Nicholas from the YouTube channel itsnicholas. Go check out his channel if you're interested in all things to do with investing. He's got lots of good information and tutorials for the casual investor with a focus on investment apps and websites. In today's video, Nicholas will be talking about why millennials can't afford property. Enjoy!
Hi guys, it's Nicholas, and if you are a millennial like me, aged somewhere between 22 to 37 years old, or born between 1981 to 1996, as you can see on the screen right now, then buying a property to live in or as an investment has probably been on your mind for some time now. Now, Macquarie Group or Macquarie Bank has released their Macquarie Property Insights Report for January 2020. And the dilemma in today's society is that quite a few millennials can't afford to buy property. And as you can see on the screen, the Macquarie Group has released this property insights report showing that the median dwelling prices in Sydney and Melbourne to be $840,000 and $670,000 respectively, and are expected to rise another 6 to 7% by the end of 2020. And if I can scroll down, you can see on the screen that Macquarie Group or Macquarie Bank, and by the way, Macquarie Group and Macquarie Bank is a large financial institution. They're listed on the ASX and they are a very reputable company, and they forecast national housing prices will rise by a further 6 to 7% by the end of 2020. And according to the Australian Bureau of Statistics, the ABS, the average weekly earnings for people aged 21 to 34 years old, so that second row, you can see the average weekly earnings for people in that age group, which is pretty close or pretty similar to the millennials age range, is $1,128, which equates to just short of $59,000 per year, as I've multiplied that 1,128 by 52 weeks in the year. And what I'm saying is that if you are earning somewhere close to this average salary of $59,000 per year, it becomes almost impossible to buy a property outright in Sydney or Melbourne, and only feasible to put down a small 10 to 20% deposit and borrow the rest from the bank. Not to mention that Australia's wage growth is 2.3%, which makes it increasingly harder to save money for a property if national housing prices are expected to increase at a higher rate. And what I mean by that is if wage growth is only increasing by 2.3% per year, so instead of earning, say, $59,000 per year on average, that increases to, I think, just over $60,000 per year the following year. But because the average housing prices Australia-wide, as you can see on the screen right now, is increasing a lot higher, you know, 6 to 7% for the year of 2020. And if these rates are, you know, on a consistent basis, then it actually makes it gradually harder and harder to get into the property market. And I mean, other than Sydney, Melbourne and Canberra, buying a house seems more affordable, as the median dwelling price in other major cities in Australia are less than $500,000. So you can see in Brisbane here, it's just under $500,000. Adelaide is, you know, it looks like on the more cheaper end, $433,000. Darwin looks quite cheap as well. And Hobart, by the sounds of it, you know, is at its, you know, record highs. And I thought I'd show you guys this pretty cool statistic released by Money Smart Australia, which is a government website. And the statistics show that people under the age of 35 in Australia spend on average $849 per week. So you can see that a lone person aged under 35 years old, so, you know, that's basically most of the millennials, they spend almost $850 per week, which means that they'll be able to save about $280 per week, because $850 or $849 is subtracted from the $1,127 or $28 that we got from the ABS. And basically, with all the maths and statistics that I've done here, the average millennial is saving about $14,500 per year. And it could take you more than 9 years to buy a property in Melbourne, or even longer in Sydney. And this is because if you need to put down, say, a minimum deposit of 20% of the property price, then you would need at least $130,000 in savings to just get you in the real estate market. Anyway, guys, that's my small little rant on why millennials can't afford to buy property. And if you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and let us know your thoughts in the comments section below about the Australian property market. See you later.